Now, we are glad to be joined by more medal finishers in the 30th Southeast Asian Games. Welcome to the show, Carla Beatriz Grabador and Jobelyn Ocampo, SEA Games bronze medalists from the women's water polo team and their head coach, Aldo Tong. Women's water polo team, Coach Aldo, Bea, and Jobelyn, congratulations.
Thank you.
Monumental bronze medal finish. Yes. All right, so Coach Aldo, I just want to ask, of course, you had limited time to prepare.
Mm-hmm.
Only you were mentioning it to me earlier. Only April lang.
Yes.
Na incorporate yung women's water polo.
Yes.
But then at the same time, with that limited time, how did you prepare your team after the SEA Games?
I suppose we had a team kasi back in 2015. Both Bea and Job were veterans for that campaign, so we had to seek their help, or more like actually they started recruiting people they knew how to play or were interested to play. So April, May, that's what we were doing, trying to teach also the sport to the new members. And then later on, we got invitations to go abroad for training, and that's what we were looking out for, just to go abroad to train.
All right, so Job, so 2015 nga nung huling pagkakataon, nung time na nagkaroon yung water polo sa SEA Games.
Yes,
but then it's a long time,
mm-hmm.
right? So you as veterans, did you have a like deep preparations in between or at the same time nung nakuha yung team ng April, what is it? It's like a crash course, or what was it like in preparing teaser teammates?
Since 2015 po kasi, we stopped for almost 4 years, because 2015 and then comes 2019, tsaka lang kami ulit naglaro. But in those 4 years time, like individually, we joined like mga aquathon and then swim, like sariling workout and exercises na lang. Pero all throughout 2019, bago pa 2018, medyo bumabalik na ulit kami mag-water polo, in hopes na medyo hindi pa kasi kami may idea noon kung talagang meron bang women's water polo na ilalagay for the lineup. But hoping kami noon, so in our own little way, nag-training na kami to start our journey para maging in shape na ulit, mabalik yung dating lakas, and then mabalik yung dating mga skills para pagdating kung meron talaga, it's just nagkaroon naman is makakasabak na ulit talaga for training na bakbakan.
Bea, how challenging was it to get the team together and at the same time to train at a limited time, knowing na it's going to be a tough competition?
To be honest, it is hard. Just to promote the Philippine women's water polo in the Philippines, it's hard. Because meron tayong parang stereotype is water polo is for men only. And also, more than the medal, we wanted to promote the sport, to promote water polo, women in sports. It's really hard, but you know, we've pushed through and I think we did great.
All right, so podium finish. Coach Aldo, what's going through your mind with your team? Of course, getting, it's the first time, right, that the Philippines bagged a bronze. But then how fulfilling is it for you guys?
Oh, it's definitely fulfilling. And like Bea said, for us, it's not just winning in SEA Games, it's more promoting the sport. Because even for men's, water polo is not popular. So, you know, we wanted to show the country that, hey, there's this sport. It's exciting. You can enjoy it. Come join us. Let's learn the sport and, you know.
How's the actual competition like, Singapore and Thailand?
Well, Thailand is strong. They have an Italian coach who's been around for maybe 6-7 years with the program. In fact, I think he handles the entire program now, men's and women's. They just won this year again for the third straight SEA Games. They go to Europe to train because of his connections. They won some tournaments there. So they're really a strong unit. I mean, if you're talking about size, they're not even tall. Most of them are like this tall lang. So I don't know how they feel going up against Thailand. They already went up against them in 2015.
I want to get your perspective on that, Job.
2015 Thailand, we were close. The game was close against Philippines and then against Thailand. But like any other teams, like when you go together along the way, you train together, they build really strong connection at each other. Unlike us, like we just train short period of time. And then, but if we go close, Thailand is really fast team. They're strong swimmers. And then I think that's the main advantage of Thailand against us. But we were able to somehow make it a close fight with them.
All right, so Bea, from your perspective, just assessing you know, the competition mm-hmm. from the past to now, looking forward to the future. Mm-hmm. What do you think needs improvement for the Philippines?
Chemistry, investment in time, and, you know, program, a long-term program for the women's water polo team.
How do you think we should do that?
We should start by as soon as possible, you know? If you wanted to win, like in any other sports, you should start thinking long-term. You shouldn't expect more on winning, more on, like, preserving and nurturing the sport.
Yes, I understand also that Job and Bea, also coach, that you also do, you know, day jobs,
yeah.
right? It's not a full-time sport. You run a business.
Kinda.
you work in the corporate yeah. industry, but mm-hmm. how is it like, at least from your perspective, Bea, that you go to work, and then yeah. at the same time, you guys meet at the time, mm-hmm. training, yeah. but how's that grind like?
So in the Philippines, hindi naman sekreto na it's hard to be an athlete here because you have to forgo the other side, like your other life. If you wanted to be an athlete, you have to focus on that because we're not compensated like professionals. Like, we can do that alone, like do the sports alone. So in preparing for the SEA Games, we had to forego our business, our work. We had sacrifices. And it's worth it.
Is it yeah. the same job?
Yeah, it's the same because I work in a corporate job in a corporate company. So for me to be able to focus on the SEA Games and training on the SEA Games, I had to quit my job. I had to fully resign because in corporate jobs, yeah, there's no indefinite leave in our company. So I need to really quit that job and have my SEA Games career that to be really my career. So every sacrifices, quitting my job is one of my biggest sacrifices. It's all worth it along the journey, like being able to play this, being able to play for the Philippines and having that flag next to my heart, it's really worth it.
Is it necessarily the same for coaches also?
Well, yeah. Talking about leaving or quitting me, I had to take a leave of absence from my day job because, number one, I mentioned we have training abroad, so I can't be full-time and, you know, not be present. So I also had to leave until the end of the year. A lot of sacrifices, financial and time.
All right, looking forward, moving forward, Coach Aldo, what are the programs in play? Are there any, you know, future tournaments or maybe trainings abroad that's in the pipeline?
You know, this year we had a lot of support going abroad, thanks to Philippine Sports Commission and Philippine Swimming Incorporated. But I don't know next year what the state would be. On the program side, we'll try to organize local competitions, international even. There might be some competitions we could join next year. But personally, there's also for basketball, there's 3-on-3. For volleyball, there's beach volleyball. There's actually beach water polo, so it's a smaller scale. And I personally believe that's the way to go if we want to promote the sport. So
now in this year's SEA Games, it is no doubt. My last question for you, Coach Aldo. It is no secret, as you mentioned, Bea, that we've just been recognizing these sports that yeah. hindi naman siya popular sa mainstream, yes. at least for water polo. I've asked this question numerous times to other sports as well. How do we generate the interest, especially for the ones, you know, that needs awareness? Diba? We want to encourage everybody. Sige, mm-hmm. join kayo. Pero how do you generate the interest first and make them love it, make them like it and love it?
Well, for one, I think the SEA Games, we hosted it. A lot of people watched. And in fact, nag-sell out yung stadium nung SEA Games. So now people want, we also have to thank the men's team because yeah. nag-trending sila because of their pandesal.
Yeah.
Yes, so people started flocking in the latter part of the tournament. So I think the awareness is there now. It's just on our end, we have to ride on it and we have to hold clinics regularly, invite people regularly just to keep the interest going.
Yes. Ayun. All right. So again, congratulations to the women's Philippine women's water polo team. So we have Jobelyn Ocampo and the Bea Grabador. All right. So Coach Aldo Tong, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Come on, finalists.
Thank you. Thank you.